How to move from a state of being fragile to a point of being agile, moving from fragile to agile. Over the past weeks, I've had a great deal of interaction with leaders and teams in terms of how they're dealing with the impact of COVID-19. It has been a massive ask of leaders and teams, of families and communities. There have been many challenges: how to get people home safely, how to ensure that they're cared for, how to ensure that they are engaged, how operations or businesses have been wrapped up, cared for, maintained, how they're being prepared for reopening, how they're being prepared for extended lockdowns. This has not been a gentle change for many people. It's been an enforced turning point. It has tested our ability to adapt. It has challenged us on multiple levels. And it's asked us whether we are agile or truly fragile. I've interacted with leaders who have been out in the trenches, fighting the battle, getting food to people, dealing with the issues day and night. Sometimes they've forgotten to get changed out of their pajamas or wash. Others have simply switched to a new normal of hibernation. Some have been completely absorbed into Microsoft Teams, Zoom, Skype, BlueJeans, and the list goes on. Fatigue has overwhelmed many. Sleep cycles have gone out, diet has gone out, exercise has gone out, emotion and reaction have heightened. Cabin fever seems to be the next pandemic. Equally, people have shared how much closer they've come to family. Where people have been stranded, humanity and the power of people has made things possible. Mothers and fathers have realized their roles again. Some parents have actually learned some new things in homeschooling and have a greater level of empathy for teachers. Gardeners and helpers have been missed, and essential workers have been recognized. Way overdue. Remotely, many nations have grown closer, and in some cases more distant in terms of their relationships with their presidents and prime ministers. This is only the beginning. In the months ahead, we will absorb and forget many of these moments. The change will continue. There will be further turning points which disrupt our lives. There will be further crises that present new ways for us to reimagine ourselves and our survival. There will be many new opportunities. At the heart of much of the advice I've given has been a message of self-care. Rest, eat well, exercise, sleep, do nice things for others, be kind to yourself, learn something new. Each of us are leaders. We lead our lives, we lead ourselves, we lead others. And this concept ripples out to families, groups, and communities. The point I've made to many is that you have to be sound and strong as the source of that leadership. The old example of a stone thrown into a pond, the ripples are directly proportional to the size of the stone and the intensity of the impact. You can't lead well if you are weak. Then, equally as important, is having empathy for others. A leader I spoke to said something that resonated with me yesterday. He talked about being able to help people return to work with dignity and respect. He shared the good work he and his leaders had done in planning how to bring people back in. Many leaders, by their very nature, are control freaks. They believe in the concept of internal locus of control. COVID-19 has tested our ability to confront and handle situations which we didn't cause. Learning from this is going to be vital. If we've made the mistake of not anticipating this fully or not being prepared enough this time, we need to know that a mistake made twice is a decision. That decision is something we will be judged on in the future. We need to develop new formulas for winning, new ways of working and interacting going forward. We need to develop new social norms and ways of treating each other. The future generations will lead us as they will grow up in a society where social distancing is a good thing. Touch, proximity, closeness, will have new definitions and sensations going forward. I fully expect to see a new trend in virtual reality as a result. Your earning potential is directly proportional to your ability to take control of a situation. The way in which we think, the way in which we process information, and the way in which we live and apply knowledge will be the game changer for many. Will we need offices in the future? Or will our homes be more like beehives? Will we live in safer, isolated yet fully connected silos and communities? Will we travel in the same way? Insular entertainment versus global travel. Here are some important approaches going forward to help you move from fragile to agile. Realize the need to stay interested, not anxious. Stay open to learning. Recognize that you will go through a range of negative emotions and destabilizing thoughts and responses as you encounter new opportunities. You may not even be up to seeing them. They may be unreal or unknown. You may miss them. Don't freak out or get anxious or panic that you have missed them or will miss them. Open yourself to learning, looking, and listening. Feel free to share and say to folks, "I feel uncomfortable." Feel safe in doing that. Feel free to be completely honest and ask for help. Remember that a person rises to the point in life where they can ask for help. Trust others to help you. Overcome the silly picture you might have had of being everyone's hero and having to solve the problems of all around you. Use this time where they might come to the fore and offer solutions and take responsibility for the success or failure of those solutions they recommend. Open the door to contributing and gaining experience and leading with you. Compromise, sacrifice, and trade-offs will be vital in the next few years. Be prepared to lose. Be prepared to let go of the past and adjust. You need to think bigger, longer term. The scoreboard is not about now. The performance of your team right now will be irrelevant in the future. The trend and recovery line is what will be admired. I've often said that the past is the past. Nothing is ever going to stay the same. Grieve over it for a few days, celebrate its value, take good memories on board, and tackle the future. Don't forget your friends. Don't abandon the ecosystem. Take them with you. Invite them along. Look for ways to make collaboration a thing that gets many of us to win together. Test where you invest. Spend money prudently. Learn quickly what works, and get behind that. Make every action count and every investment count. Embrace agility. #OneGoal.